Welcome to a quick video tutorial on using complex numbers in Desmos. To get started exploring complex numbers, we will head to the scientific calculator at desmos.com/scientific. Let's start by attempting to compute the square root of negative 1. Since no real number can be multiplied by itself to equal negative 1, the calculator displays undefined. However, if we go to the calculator settings menu using the wrench icon and toggle on complex mode, we'll see how our previous answer now displays as I. This imaginary unit I is how the complex number system defines the square root of negative 1. And just like we would expect the square root of negative 1 times the square root of negative 1 to equal negative 1, I times I, or I squared, is equal to negative 1. A complex number, such as 2 plus 5i, consists of a real part and an imaginary part. The function real of 2 plus 5i returns the real part, 2, and imag of 2 plus 5i returns the imaginary part, 5. Once we understand the components of a complex number, we can also perform computations. For example, we can add two complex numbers, 2 plus 5i plus 4 minus 3i. The sum, 6 plus 2i, can be found by separately adding the corresponding real and imaginary parts. We can also take the product of these complex numbers, which results in 23 plus 14i. This can be computed manually using the distributive property, taking special care when multiplying 5i by negative 3i, remembering that I squared is equal to negative 1. While the scientific calculator is the ideal tool for performing calculations with complex numbers, we can also visualize complex numbers using the graphing calculator at desmos.com/calculator. Again, we will first go to the graph settings menu and toggle on complex mode. Once enabled, complex numbers are plotted as points, where the x-coordinate represents the real part and the y-coordinate represents the imaginary part. For example, the number 2 plus 5i is visualized at the point 2, 5, and the style settings can be adjusted just like a point in the xy plane. We can also toggle on the label to see the complex number value on the graph, or make the point draggable. We can assign complex numbers to variables to make them simpler to work with. Let's define z equals 2 plus 5i and w equals 4 minus 3i. Now we can easily calculate z plus w or z times w and observe the visual representation of these calculations. In addition to the real and imag functions mentioned earlier, we can also use the conj function to plot and evaluate the conjugate of a complex number, which flips the sign of the imaginary part and is commonly used when dividing complex numbers. We can type conj of z and then drag our original point z to observe the graphical relationship between these points. Learn more about complex numbers, including viewing a collection of example graphs and other applications, in the Desmos Help Center. We can't wait to see the unimaginable ways that you will use complex numbers.